This video is a follow-up from one of my previous videos where a lightning strike destroyed this SunGold Power 24 volt inverter charger. In that previous video, I sent it to an electronics repair shop hoping they could fix it. That attempt failed. So in this video, I'm going to try something new. Let's see if I can get it working this time. If you haven't seen the video where my SunGold Power 24 volt inverter charger was struck by lightning, I encourage you to check that video out before watching this one. I'll put a link up here and down in the video description. In that video, I go through all the details of the lightning strike, the attempts I made to fix it, the protections I added all around my house to help protect against further lightning strikes. Okay, so what's new in this video? Well, first I want to give you an update on this Jindal 3000 watt 24 volt backup inverter I've been using. I was just using it as a backup. I've been using it ever since the SunGold Power has been out of commission. Well, it's not been going so well, really. It works well when it's powering the circuits, but there is one big issue. And that happens whenever the charge controllers are charging the battery during the day. The inverter is throwing an overvoltage alarm a couple times a day, probably. And obviously this is very irritating when I'm trying to power things 24/7 around the house. So to isolate the issue and see, you know, exactly what's going on here, I turned off the Bougie RV controller and I focused solely on the Victron. And that's because of their mobile app. It's a very nice mobile app. I was trying to identify where the voltage spike happened and how much was it. I did find the voltage spike. It was only up to around 28.5 volts, really. This screenshot you see here is an actual moment where the inverter did shut down. And as you see here, it only goes up to around 29 volts. And this inverter is supposed to support up to 32 volts. I never had this issue with the SunGold Power inverter. So I did some Googling and I found that other people have been having this exact same issue. I looked into the manual and I found this. It says, basically, do not use the inverter when the battery is charging. Well, that defeats the purpose of what I wanted to use this inverter for. It's to provide power 24/7 around some of the circuits around my house. So this inverter works good, except for that one big issue, and I guess this just is not good for my situation. Okay, so back to the SunGold Power inverter. So I gave up on fixing the unit by replacing the damaged MOSFETs. All the damaged ones were replaced, but something else inside must be damaged that's just not visible. So instead, I ended up ordering these replacement boards from SunGold Power to replace those fried ones. Here are the boards they sent me. SunGold Power is actually good to work with this. I did buy the inverter charger and the replacement boards with my own money. I ended up paying $455, which is a little better than I originally thought. They had to ship them all the way from the plant in China, so it took about 5 weeks for them to arrive. I am affiliated with SunGold Power, and I will leave a link below if you're interested in this inverter charger. So to replace these boards, the first thing I did was to take several detailed photographs and videos of the existing boards and the connections as they were installed. I wanted to make sure I had a reference of something to look at to make sure I put it back together correctly. After looking at it carefully, it seemed like it should be fairly straightforward to replace these. There were only a few screws holding these in, but there were several wires, and I needed to be absolutely certain I hooked them up correctly. This unit had not been powered on in weeks, but I did double check there's no voltage remaining anywhere inside before I started replacing these boards. Removing the bad boards was very straightforward, and I was careful not to damage anything. The new boards did not come with a couple of things, such as the standoff screws that separates the boards. I had to use the old ones, which was fine. I connected the two boards together before installing them in the unit, and I connected everything back up. I did have to refer to the pictures and videos a couple of times. I'm so glad I took those pictures for reference. I installed the cover back on. There were actually four wires connecting the cover to the boards. I actually put all this back together yesterday and tested, so I'm going to actually step back in time a day to when I actually tested this for the very first time. The setup I used here for this test is not a permanent solution. It would be unsafe for normal use. This is just temporary setup. When I hook it back up for real, it will have all the proper protections in place. Okay, so here's a moment of truth. So everything's hooked up. The battery's hooked up. And I'm going flipping the switch now. Okay, this light came on. These lights flashed. This light's on now. The display's not working. I hear a slight buzz, but I'm going to turn it off. And I'm going to go quadruple check everything, every connection inside. Okay, attempt number two. I confirmed everything is hooked up. Same lights flashed, the display is not working. Now I hear a slight buzz, So I'm actually going to check the voltage on here to see if it's actually working or not. And it's DC. 120.7 volts, so we are putting output. Okay, so that's good. It is working. But the display is not working for some reason, so let me open that back up and triple check all those connections. Okay, so I think I found the issue. This little connector right here for the display on top, that little white piece right there was pushed out much further than I remembered. So I plugged it in and then I really pushed on it hard. And I think what happened is that little piece had slid out so far that when I plugged it in, the pins were not connecting. So I think that that's what it was. The pins were just not connecting there. And when I shoved everything in there really hard, it made it connect. So let's go test again. Okay, so we are at the battery hooked back up and ready for the test. I think the display is going to work this time. Let's hit the switch. Yes, working. Welcome. All these lights seem to be working. Let me turn off this light here so we can see the lights. Yeah, this light here is working. This light's working. We tested the AC already, but I'm going to plug in a drill here just to see, make sure the load works. Nice. All right, I just need to seal this thing up and we're gonna head back now.
Where?
Back to the future.
So as you saw, replacing the boards in this unit actually did fix it. I had my son come out and help me reinstall this. Now we're back in business. I'm so glad to have this SunGold Power Inverter Charger back in action. It ran flawlessly for about a year until that lightning strike. And I've been using it over the past day. It's been working great, and I'm sure it will continue to work great. I guess if I wanted to look on the bright side of this lightning experience, I learned a lot more about lightning protection. And I did install lightning protection across my whole house and solar panels, which will hopefully protect against this happening again. And it gave me a reason to make a couple more videos. So if you're interested in the video where I originally built this 24-volt DIY solar generator system, I'll put the video up here and down in the description below. Thanks for watching.